The valence bond theory. Valence bond theory explains covalent bonding as an overlap of either pure atomic orbitals or hybridized atomic orbitals between individual atoms sharing a pair of electrons and involved in a covalent bond. The head-on overlap sharing of these pair of electrons is referred to as a sigma bond. Further, the valence bond theory supports the Vesper theory that we've looked at previously. Let's take a look at methane again as an example. Methane, CH4. We saw that methane has four regions of high electron density because there's four bonding pairs of electrons around the central atom. And the valence bond theory states that electrons will arrange themselves in space as far apart as possible in order to minimize the like charge repulsion. And so we end up, when we have four regions of high electron density, having a tetrahedral shape. We saw that the valence bond theory then also correctly predicts for methane that the four individual atomic orbitals on carbon, the S and the three P's, hybridize or mix. The atomic orbitals mix to form four new hybrid orbitals called sp3. And the calculated shape of the sp3 orbitals allows for that tetrahedral arrangement. Further, that now we think of these orbitals or regions where the electrons exist as hybrid orbitals, each one being an sp3 orbital, and also that there is an overlap along these axes of the bond between the pure atomic orbital on the hydrogen, the 1s orbital on the hydrogen, and the sp3 orbital on the carbon, and that head-on overlap results in a sigma bond. Okay, so we see that in the methane, we would predict four sigma bonds based on the head-on overlap between the four hybridized orbitals and the four individual atomic orbitals. Let's take a look at another example. Let's look at the example for methane. Excuse me. Let's look at the example for ammonia. Now, ammonia also is predicted to have a tetrahedral electronic geometry according to the Vesper theory. Vesper prediction here is that we have the tetrahedral electronic geometry, all right, because we have four regions of high electron density for the ammonia. We have three bonding regions. And then we have the non-bonding pair of electrons, or the unshared pair of electrons, or lone pair of electrons on the central atom as well. And so because of that, the shape, the molecular shape, doesn't look like a tetrahedron anymore. The molecular geometry in this case is called trigonal pyramidal. Okay, the molecular geometry now. All right, let's try to then rationalize this shape with the valence bond theory. Now, if we look at the hydrogen, of course, each of the hydrogens is going to have 1s, and so we're going to predict the 1s pure atomic orbital to overlap head-on with some sort of hybridized orbital on the nitrogen. So if we focus on the nitrogen, the pure atomic orbitals in the valence shell of the nitrogen, it's 2s2, 2p3. There's five valence electrons in the valence shell of the pure atomic orbitals on the nitrogen. And just to be more correct, I'm going to separate the energy between the S and the P, indicating correctly that the P has a higher energy. Now, if we think of this situation where we must have four equal places on the nitrogen in order to have this tetrahedral electronic geometry, then we know we're going to have four new hybrid orbitals. And those four new hybrid orbitals, again, are the sp3 hybridized orbitals. In this case, we had 5 electrons on the central atom's valence shell. And we can see, where do those 5 electrons go? Well, they fall out into these now degenerate sp3 orbitals. We have one pair in one of the orbitals right here, and then we have 3 individuals that could account for head-on bonding between the 1s or electrons in each one of these hydrogens. So if we have a sp3, 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 all arranged as far apart in space as possible as a tetrahedron looking like the shape of the sp3 orbital, we can explain the bonding. We have head-on bonding between the nitrogen and the hydrogen, the hybridized nitrogen orbital, and the pure atomic orbital for the hydrogen. And so we end up with then the last hybridized orbital containing a pair of unshared electrons, which we can explain as we go from the different energy to the degenerate 4 sp3 orbitals. So again, indeed, the electronic geometry here is supported by the sp3 hybridization, the tetrahedral electronic geometry. The bonding, we would predict here that we have formed 3 sigma bonds from the head-on overlap of the individual hydrogens and the nitrogens. So in this case, the valence bond theory again supports the Vesper theory very nicely.